Hello and welcome to SCANS eCampus. SCANS eCampus is a gold-approved learning partner of ACCA. On this channel, we bring you demo videos of different courses available at SCANS eCampus. So don't forget to subscribe to our channel to get notifications of additional videos and hit the like button. We can now begin one of the most important areas of your syllabus, audit opinion. If you look at the audit process from the start, the first thing is accepting an audit, at which point we studied some steps that the auditor needs to perform before an audit engagement is accepted. Then comes planning, where an audit strategy is formulated and risk assessment is conducted. After that, controls are tested, based on which substantive testing is performed. After that, a comprehensive review of financial statements is conducted, and the next step is opinion, which is where we are right now in our syllabus. Let's look at how different issues within financial statements have an impact on the audit opinion that we are going to issue. Now remember, this is one of the most examinable areas in your syllabus, and it may feature in section A as well as section B of your exam. I can say it with confidence that in all of the attempts of your audit exam, audit opinion has featured in one way or the other. So it is very important for students to have an in-depth knowledge of audit opinion and how different issues within financial statements affect the audit opinion. Let's first look at the different types of audit opinions. The first type is unmodified, while the second type is modified. If you look at the literal meanings of these words, unmodified would mean unchanged, while modified would mean changed. So unmodified audit opinion is also called clean opinion, and simply put, it means that the auditor would write, in our opinion, financial statements present a true and fair view of the business. While modification means that one or another issue has affected our assessment of financial statements. There are three kinds of modifications that the auditor can make to the audit opinion. The first is a qualified opinion, second is an adverse opinion, and the third is a disclaimer. Remember, all three are given in three different or more different circumstances. So let's look at how different issues will affect the auditor's opinion. The first is an unmodified opinion, which is also called a clean opinion. This means that all material misstatements have been adjusted, and the adjustments that have not been made are either immaterial in isolation or they're immaterial in aggregate as well. So misstatements could have been aggregated and their aggregate could still be immaterial, hence there will be no impact on the audit opinion. Now remember, for example, let's suppose there are several errors of $100, $200 and $300. Let's suppose planning materiality is $900. If you look at all of these misstatements, A, B and C, none of them are material in isolation. If you aggregate them, the total comes down to $600. Since $600 is also below $900, it is still immaterial, and that is what this line means. So, when we give a clean opinion, listen to this carefully, it does not mean that financial statements are absolutely free from all errors and fraud. A clean opinion means that financial statements are free from material errors and fraud. There could still be immaterial misstatements in financial statements, and the auditor would still give a clean opinion on them. So this is exactly why we do not give absolute assurance or guarantees. While we can be reasonably sure that financial statements are correct, we cannot be absolutely sure that there are no errors or fraud within financial statements. So that was unmodified opinion. Let's now look at the first type of modified opinion, which is a qualified opinion. Now, qualified opinion is given when there is a material misstatement in one account balance or class of transactions. Just to recap, account balances are items in statement of financial position, while classes of transactions are items within the statement of profit or loss. So let's suppose that inventory was being checked, and within inventory there is a misstatement of $500. Since planning materiality is $400, this is a material for us. So this is a material misstatement. Since these $500 are material to financial statements, they will affect the auditor's opinion. However, and listen to this closely, the rest of financial statements are absolutely correct. So, in a situation where there is a material misstatement, however, it only affects one account balance or class of transaction, we can give a qualified opinion. Within qualified opinion, our wordings would be, except for the matters highlighted, financial statements present a true and fair view of the business. Which really means that other than this, all else in financial statements is fine. Another circumstance where qualified opinion may be issued is the inability of an auditor to gather sufficient appropriate audit evidence in a material area. Remember, is the key word here. One material area, account balance or class of transactions. For example, let's suppose total planning materiality is $10,000. Out of this, the auditor was checking inventory, and within inventory, $11,000 worth of inventory was held at a third-party warehouse. The auditor could not get an external confirmation from that third party, and the auditor could not visit that warehouse to check the existence and completeness of inventory. Other than this, all else is fine within financial statements. In this circumstance as well, the auditor can give a qualified opinion since the auditor was unable to gather sufficient appropriate audit evidence in material area, which is isolated in one account balance or class of transaction. The second kind of modification on an audit opinion is adverse opinion. Adverse opinion is given when there is a material and pervasive misstatement in financial statements. Now, this is very, very important. We need to see what pervasive is. So, pervasive is anything that affects multiple account balances and classes of transactions at the same time, or has the ability to turn profit into losses. Remember that. So, an adverse opinion is given when there is a material and pervasive misstatement in financial statements. Now, let's see how this is different from qualified opinion. In a qualified opinion, a misstatement may be material, but it is not pervasive. For pervasive and material misstatements, an adverse opinion is given. Adverse opinion would mean the auditor would say, in our opinion, financial statements do not present a true and fair view of the business. That would simply be saying that financial statements are incorrect. For example, the business, in the auditor's opinion, is not a going concern, and financial statements should be prepared on a breakup basis or on alternative basis. Management, however, disagrees and management wants to prepare financial statements on a normal basis, so on going concern basis. Since this is an issue that affects multiple account balances and classes of transactions, like I said before, assets, liabilities, their valuation will all be affected. This is a material and pervasive misstatement in financial statements, and hence an adverse opinion will be given. The third kind of modification on the audit opinion is a disclaimer. A disclaimer is given when the auditor is unable to gather sufficient appropriate audit evidence in a material and pervasive area. So, how is this different from a qualified opinion? Pervasiveness of the area is different. Remember what pervasive means: anything that affects multiple account balances or classes of transactions. So if the auditor is unable to gather sufficient appropriate audit evidence in multiple account balances and classes of transactions, or in an area that has the ability to turn profit into losses, then a disclaimer can be given. For example, revenue ledger, all of it was corrupted or encrypted during the year when it was being transferred from the old system to the new system. Revenue is amounting to $1 million in 1 year, while materiality is, let's suppose, $50,000. Now, revenue is pervasive because it has the ability to turn profit into losses. Hence, since the auditor will not be able to vouch or trace any transaction within revenue, the auditor will give a disclaimer in financial statements in the audit report, which would essentially mean that the auditor would want to withhold opinion on this year's financial statements because they were unable to gather sufficient appropriate audit evidence in a material and pervasive area. So remember that the auditor's opinion could be of two types. The first is unmodified, which means unchanged or clean opinion. This would also mean that all material errors have been adjusted within financial statements. Or the second kind of opinion is modified, which also means changed. There are three kinds of modifications that can be made to the audit opinion. One is qualified, the second is adverse, and the third is a disclaimer. Remember, a qualified opinion is given when there is a material misstatement or inability to gather sufficient appropriate audit evidence in a material area. A being the key word here, one account balance or class of transaction. Adverse opinion is given when there is a material and pervasive misstatement. Pervasive being key here. Pervasive means anything that affects multiple account balances and classes of transactions or has the ability to turn profit into losses. While a disclaimer is given when the auditor is unable to gather sufficient appropriate audit evidence in a material and pervasive area, which means affecting more than one account balance class of transaction or has the ability to turn profit into losses. In a nutshell, that is audit opinion.
If you like this video, visit our website www.scamsecampus.com to purchase the complete course at affordable prices. Register today at no cost and access our free 10-day trial.